Welcome to the Surewest Sports Show for the week of June 7th. Well, it's all baseball all the time as the Sac Joaquin section closes out their high school sports season with the Division 1 through Division 7 section championship games in baseball. So stay tuned for the Surewest Sports Show coming at you front and center. Welcome back for another edition of the Surewest Sports Show. I'm your host, Mike Finnerty. Well, the 2009-2010 school year has finally come to a close, and so has the high school sports season as the section championships in baseball were played out this past week, and we have plenty of highlights and interviews to bring to you from the Division 1 through Division 4 games, as well as the Division 7 game. We'll have our usual sports chat interview, spotlight interview, trivia question, players of the week, and a whole lot more. So let's get the show started with our highlights. Now to the Division I Championships, and on Wednesday we were out at American River College where the Elk Grove Thundering Herd were taking on the defending back-to-back champion, the Jesuit Marauders. Jesuit came into this championship match from the winner's bracket side, so for Elk Grove to win the Division I North Championship, they would need to win this game and force a second and deciding game that would be played immediately afterward. Getting the start in this one for Jesuit would be the ace of their staff and senior Dan Child, who will play next year for Oregon State. And for Elk Grove, it was their junior star, J.D. Davis. Jesuit scored the first run in this game, and it came in the top of the second when Logan James delivered with a base hit that would score Justin Higley to put the Marauders up 1-0. In the bottom of the second, Elk Grove countered, and they did so with the long ball when J.D. Davis helped himself by launching this leadoff homer that would tie the game at 1-1, and that wouldn't be the last time we would hear from Davis as his teammates and fans go crazy following the big hit. Over the next two innings, both pitchers took control of the game, where both allowed just one hit each, but in the bottom of the fifth, the Elk Grove Thundering Herd grabbed the lead for the first time in this game, where they scored two runs, with one run coming on this Will Soto RBI single that brought home Colby Brenner, and now Elk Grove was out in front by a score of 3-1 as the game moved to the top of the sixth. From there, it was just more Davis as he rings up his fifth strikeout of the day, as that would be the last inning on the hill for Davis, but that wasn't the last of Davis's big plays in this game, because in the home half of the sixth, Davis continued to swing the hot bat as he goes deep for the second time of the day with this monster launch for yet another solo homer as Davis makes his way around the bases before touching home to make it now a 4-1 game with Elk Grove just three outs away from forcing a game two. Elk Grove head coach Jeff Carlson turned to Jake Rodriguez to pitch the final inning, and Rodriguez closed it out to get the save as Elk Grove gets the 4-1 win as both teams now prepared for game two that would follow after a 30-minute break in between games. Now to game two, where the winner of this one would capture the North Subsection Championship in a meeting in the Division I section final with the St. Mary's Rams of Stockton. Right away, the game belonged to Elk Grove, and it started in the top of the first inning with this RBI single off the bat of Davis. The hit would score Soto from third to make it a 1-0 Elk Grove lead after one. In the second inning, Elk Grove was back at it again as they were looking for more, and once again it was Will Soto picking up his second hit in as many at-bats, as the Soto hit would score Joe Betancourt to make it a 2-0 Elk Grove lead. Still in the second inning, Elk Grove was far from being done. Jorge Vina followed Soto with an RBI single of his own. That would score Dom Nunez to now make it a 3-0 game. Two batters later, it was that guy Davis again, and this time he delivers with what would be a triple for his second hit of the game and his fourth of the day, as this hit would score a pair of runs to up the Thundering Herd lead now to 5-0, as there appeared to be no answer for stopping the potent Elk Grove offense. Meanwhile, as Elk Grove was racking up the runs on the offensive end, senior pitcher Zach Majewski was dialed in and dealing on the mound as Majewski worked a three-hit shutout through four innings of play. Elk Grove added another run in the fourth to up their lead to 6-0, and then the Herd worked on putting this game away in the fifth and final inning, and they did just that as they scored five more runs on five hits, including this three-run homer by senior Jake Rodriguez, as Elk Grove would go out in style with an 11-0 win as they would run rule the Marauders, ending this one in five innings. Soto led the way with three hits, Davis had two hits, and Majewski pitched all five shutout innings, allowing just four hits to pick up the victory. Now to the Division I final that was played at the Klein Family Field on the campus of the University of Pacific in Stockton. Meeting up to determine the Division I section champion would be Elk Grove and the St. Mary's Rams of Stockton. On Wednesday, St. Mary's took game one of the series by a score of 10-7. So on Thursday, these two teams met up for game two, where St. Mary's looked to put an end to the series. St. Mary's scored a run in the first, but later added to their 1-0 lead where they scored four runs in the third to take what appeared to be a commanding 5-0 lead. Elk Grove got back in the game in the home half of the third inning when Jake Rodriguez took this St. Mary's pitch over the left field fence for a two-run homer to cut into the St. Mary's lead, which is now 5-2, as Rodriguez is congratulated by his teammates who sense this one's not over. This game would certainly see its fair share of scoring, and that continued in the top of the fourth when St. Mary's answered the Rodriguez homer by posting a five-run fourth that pushed the St. Mary's lead to 10-2, added two more runs in the fifth to make it 12-3, as Elk Grove appeared to be on the ropes and on the brink of being run ruled after five innings. But wait, Elk Grove wasn't about to give up yet, and they didn't, as they used the fifth and sixth innings to rally all the way back to cut the St. Mary's lead to 13-12. And when Will Soto stole home on this pitch that got away from the St. Mary's catcher, Soto slid home, beat the throw to tie the score at 13-13, heading to the seventh and final inning. From there, St. Mary's put this game away with another offensive explosion that saw the Rams go for seven runs in the top of the seventh as they regained the lead and then some, going up 20-13. St. Mary's closed it out, getting the final three outs of the game to secure the victory in the Division I section championship, their second overall in school history and their first since 1982. St. Mary's avenged their 2007 title game loss to Elk Grove with a tremendous offensive performance. The win put an official end to the baseball season as we congratulate the St. Mary's Rams and all the section champions from this past spring. See the Surewest Sports Show van in a parking lot at a game that you're attending. That means we're at your game, so be sure to say hi and give me any feedback regarding the show. As just a reminder, the Surewest Sports Show has a page on Facebook as well as MySpace, and you can follow me daily on Twitter where I'll bring you game updates, my experiences in the community, and any news of the day. We want to thank you for watching another edition of the Surewest Sports Show. Remember, you can catch a new show every Wednesday at 7 p.m. on Surewest Cable Channel 702, where the show repeats throughout the week. You can also see the show online by going to surewestsports.com. If you have any questions, be sure to email me at mike.finnerty@surewestsports.com. And we'll see you next week.